This time on Engine Masters, you're going to find out which horsepower killer is our biggest fan. This is Engine Masters presented by Amsoil and sponsored by Mr. Gasket and Earl's Vapor Guard Hose. Now, normally on this show, we are trying to make horsepower. This time, we're trying to kill horsepower, and we're gonna succeed. Every one of these cooling fans that's mechanically driven off the front of your engine is going to take some horsepower to spin. As they're moving air, they're gonna give you some parasitic drag. Which one, though, takes the most horsepower, and which one takes the least? That's what we're gonna find out when we bolt them all up to our 350 small block Chevy engine. Now, every one of these fans is 18 inches in diameter. Every one of them has 6 blades, but there's different designs. There's an OE type clutch fan. There is a plastic flex fan. There's an aluminum low profile fan. And then there's the very old school steel fixed blade fan. There's gonna be one winner here and 3 absolute losers. We're gonna go find out which is which right now. Ready for your Amsoil info? Here's what I would normally do with an engine like this. The premium protection oil. This motor is so tame, you could drive it everywhere, any day. This is a nice, good synthetic for a daily driver. It can stick in the engine for, 7,000 miles. But Amsoil recommended that instead we use the Dominator racing oil. Now, the additive package in this has more zinc in it, more things for racing, and there's only so many additives you can put in. So it has fewer dispersants and fewer detergents in it, but it's more stable with temperature. And we might be seeing very small changes in horsepower on this fan test, and so they wanted to use an oil that would be super stable regardless of temperature, so that's what we're gonna pour in this thing. Okay, we've got our little small block hung on the dyno, and basically that thing is just an implement of RPM at this point. That's all we really needed for it. That and a testing instrument for seeing how much power it's gonna eat. We're gonna give you the baseline here. We've already warmed it up. We've already got the thing consistent. It, makes the same pull every single time so that we can see what's going on once we start putting fans on it. So, fire it up. Let's see what the baseline number is.
It's not a bundle of power, but it's certainly consistent and healthy. And
it's the ultimate average small block Chevy.
And it runs really smooth.
So here's what we got. It just made 406.9 pound-feet of torque at 3,900 RPM. And up top, we're looking at 349 horsepower at 5,200 RPM. So pretty average little small block Chevy, but that's all we need to know to move on and start killing power with
now
cooling fans.
Now the fun comes.
Yeah.
It's going to be surprising, I think, to see what the...
Oh, fans are going to kill power.
I don't think they're going to make that much difference.
Here we go again, adversity at its finest.
No, I mean,
whatever side
just,
whatever we say,
it's not that.
He just goes to the other side.
It's not
the dark
that at all. I mean, it's just
I
a
say
fan.
The worst fan is going to kill 30 horsepower.
I'd say 12 or
let's
18.
Go pick which one we're going to put on first. We're going to run these fans in order from the one that we think will eat the least power to the one that is the worst. We think this is going to be the best. It's a clutch fan. The way these work is either they're thermal like this one or they're RPM dependent, and they're designed so that when it's cold, it's not driving the fan as aggressively as when it's warm. And then the RPM dependent ones that don't have this coil right here have fluid inside them that gets thrown out in a way that the clutch deactivates so it's not spinning as much as high RPM. But because it's cold in here, we think this clutch fan is going to eat the least power of the group. When we have done this before, we've run an alternator, an electric fan, as the baseline. But the fact of the matter is, you're running an alternator on your car whether you have an electric fan or not. And the electric fan draws like 30 amps, but so that's maybe 1 horsepower that isn't even measurable on the alternator drag. That's why we don't have an alternator on this. The other thing you're gonna see us do here is we're gonna hang this radiator in front of all the fans with a shroud on it. And that's because the fans are gonna tend to eat more power if they're just dangling out there in free air. But this is more realistic as to what you're gonna see in a car because it's gonna be in the shroud and it's gonna have to be drawing through the radiator. Here's one thing about the clutch fan. Look, you can spin it now independently of the engine. And that's how the clutch works. If this was really hot, it would be engaged more and have more drag on it. Here's one thing you do need to know about the fan clearance. You want like 1/2 to 3/4 of an inch of tip clearance to the shroud. You don't want it further away than that. And you want the fan blade about halfway concealed by the shroud, which you can see we've got here also.
So this That's is pretty like good alignment, isn't it?
The ideal situation, yeah. Ready?
Rock solid.
Wow, that's great.
I can't wait to see what it does.
I know, I'm kind of interested in this test too. It'll be cool. Because I know that electric fans are the best choice for horsepower, but then you have to listen to them and wire them and have all that amp draw.
Yeah, and it really taxes the whole electrical system.
Yeah. Have a look. 400 pound-feet of torque. So we ate pretty much 7 pound-feet of torque and 14 horsepower that time.
Oh, wow.
Our new peaks, 400 pound-feet of torque and 335.0 horsepower. If you look at the curve here, red is with no fan at all and black is with that clutch fan, you can see. I'm surprised. Well, I was about to say I'm surprised that it didn't eat more horsepower as RPM increased, but it did.
It does.
If you look at the difference here, it does diverge. So the more RPM, the less it likes it. Boy, wait till we put that fixed fan on there.
That's gonna be a lot worse.
So clutch fan, -7 pound-feet, -14 horsepower. Let's go to a flex fan. Next up, we decided to go with a plastic flex fan because it has softer blades than the steel one, so we figure that it's probably gonna eat less power. The theory on these is as RPM increase and it's drawing more air, that these blades flatten out like this and therefore take less of a bite of the air and eat less horsepower. One thing you do need to pay attention to if you're installing a fan is making sure you're spinning it the right direction, because there is such a thing as a reverse rotation fan if the belt arrangement on the front of the engine spins the water pump the wrong direction. Did you take the bolt? Okay, plastic flex fan, ready to rip. Okay, plastic flex fan, I'm almost wondering if it's gonna be better than the clutch.
Never know.
We just made 388.3 pound-feet at 3,800, and the horsepower, 325.1.
Wow.
At 5,100, that is pathetic. We just lost 18.6 pound-feet of torque. Looking at the horsepower number, we just lost 23.9 horsepower. From no fan to plastic flex fan.
That plastic flex fan.
You know, when you said 30, I
junk.
Thought you were maybe crazy.
No.
But
I've seen this.
Yeah.
First barbecue.
I've seen it too, but I just thought with the fan and all that, and the shroud and everything in front of it, I couldn't see it taking, you know.
Wow, that's bad. Okay, steel flex
this is
fan.
A progression. Yikes.
Next up, steel flex fan. Although, to be fair, I don't know if I can call this a flex fan, because look, these
aluminum
blades are aluminum and hard. They're usually stainless
flexing
and flimsy, so unfortunately I bought kind of the wrong thing. You can see that the plastic fan has a lot more bite to the blade than this one. So this might be actually our best one yet. It's gonna be hard to know. Because this fan is so much shallower in the pitch of its blades, it is not sunk into the shroud as much as we would really like. Next up, we've got our fixed aluminum fan. I thought I was ordering a flex fan, but it's actually not. And I think there's a good chance this makes more power than the plastic one, because it doesn't have as much pitch in the blade.
I think you're right.
Find out.
All good with that.
Whoa! but still killing power.
Yeah.
It's not much better, is it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was 5 or 6 horsepower better.
Look at the overlay. So we just found out that that aluminum fan versus no fan at all kills 12 pound-feet and 20.3 horsepower. So not as bad as the plastic one, as you can see here on this curve. The black line is the aluminum fan that we just tested, and the plastic one is on the red line. But
it's interesting before how they just kind of completely diverged, and now they diverge and then converge again.
You know why?
Plastic's flattening out.
It's flattening out.
Finally, at that much speed, it's finally flattening out.
Yep, takes that much RPM, 5,000, before that plastic fan started to...
Only takes as much power as a fixed aluminum blade.
Right, exactly.
It's okay.
Well, the last one is going to be the fixed factory type steel fan. That's the one that I'm going with. Maybe with the radiator off, it's killing 30.
I'm going to say it kills closer to 40 with the radiator out of the way, but we can test that after this.
I'd say 28.
Bolt it up. Let's go. It's,
the plastic's going to be the worst, I think.
Okay, last one. We're going to install what we assumed was going to be the worst fan, which is this factory type steel non-flexible fan. But I don't know, the plastic one could be worse. It's all about, look at the pitch of the blade. See how there's like a 90 degree cut on that blade, whereas this one's more shallow. So who knows what's going to happen here. Okay, ready?
Here we go.
Truth.
This is all of our number one picks, so we'll have to see how smart we are or aren't.
We all said this is the worst, right?
Yeah.
It will be.
But then I was stunned by the plastic fan, so I don't know.
The plastic fan is pretty bad. This will be worse.
Winner is.
Bam! Yeah. I called it.
Now you nailed it.
30 horsepower gone with the OE type fan. I killed 30 horsepower and 18.8 pound feet of torque. Wow! Okay, red line, no fan at all. Black line is this fixed factory steel fan. Look at that!
You know what's interesting? Uses the same amount of fuel.
Right.
As with no fan.
Because the cylinder is making the same amount of horsepower.
Yeah, but it's just the fan. It takes that much more power to run the fan, and that's what ends up with the magic.
Right.
That's crazy.
So the takeaway is you really don't want that set up on your hot rod.
No, you really don't. Yeah. I'm not sure you want it on anything.
Yeah.
Okay, I have to know. Let's go take the shroud off and find out what it does in free air.
Nothing.
Think it's not going to make a difference?
I'm still saying more. I'm still saying it's going to take more.
I bet you it'll take less.
Nope. Well, there's only one way to find out. Why are we sitting here?
We decided to remove the shroud. We hadn't originally thought about doing that, but I think we all agree that the more available air that the fan can bite, the more power it's going to draw. So we decided to go ahead and remove the shroud because we've all seen guys running around with just a radiator, no shroud. Not a whole lot different than this, and I think you're going to be amazed to see how much power they're giving up.
This side up.
The cap goes up.
Yeah.
Thanks for that tech tip.
It drains a lot faster with this now, though.
Okay, we just pulled the shroud off the radiator because our theory is that the fan's going to bite more air that way and kill even more power. Dulcich says nothing. Let's find out. Didn't care. It was actually a little better, right? So with a shroud on the engine, it made 388 pound-feet of torque and 318 horsepower. We took the shroud off, it made 326 horsepower, which is better, and 388 pound-feet of torque. So something different aerodynamically is going on than what we expected.
Gosh, it's baffling, isn't it, guys?
Dulcich was right. I'll say it out loud.
All right.
So that's a wrap on our fan testing. We have to go come up with brilliant conclusions now.
Okay.
Yeah.
I've already had my fun.
Me too.
So you in the market for an electric fan?
Man, I feel like I got punched in the gut.
Why?
Oh man, look at all the horsepower we lost with those fans.
30 horsepower with the worst one.
I was never expecting it to be like that huge of a loss. That's like a cam change in reverse.
I know.
Wow. But
I called it right on the nose.
Oh, I know, you hit it 30 horsepower. I thought it'd be like 11, 12, 13 maybe.
Here's the thing though. I think that the loss from the fan, the parasitic drag, is fixed rather than a percentage of loss. In other words, even if this made 800 horsepower, spinning that fan 5,200 RPM is going to lose 30 no matter what engine it's attached to.
Yeah, I think you're on to something with that, but what if you were zinging that thing to 7,500? It'd be even
worse.
That's
even worse. We only ran this to 55, 52. If you had more RPM than that, the loss from the fans would be even more devastating.
Well, that's why this test kind of destroyed me. I've got to change fans on everything I've got.
I know.
Oh, man.
Kind of life-altering. That's what happens when you watch Engine Masters. Information you need to know. Get to the garage. Rip off that fan. Put on an electric.
Information I don't want to know.
I know. Makes life more complicated. See you next time on Engine Masters presented by Amsoil. We do Engine Masters every single month, and episodes premiere at MotorTrend On Demand about a month before they show up on YouTube. What that means is there's a new episode that you can watch right now at MotorTrendOnDemand.com. Here's a preview. This time on Engine Masters, we're gonna find out how Steve Dulcich home-ported a set of cylinder heads to make big, stinky power for free. Go check out this episode of Engine Masters now at Motor Trend On Demand.
You're in trouble, Dulcich.
Oh, no. I gotta admit,
we just gagged him. That was like three-quarter throttle.
You guys punked. You guys just totally dogged me on that. I thought I was about 10 bucks.
Completely.
Oh, man.